Hi there, children. Let us start a very interesting chapter called Reproduction in Animals. Now see, in earlier topics, we've covered the process of digestion, circulation, respiration, right? We studied them in the previous classes. And we know that these processes are essential, means necessary, for the survival of every individual. We have also learned about the process of reproduction in plants. And we know that reproduction is essential for the continuation of a species. A particular plant or animal ki jati continue ho, उसके लिए उनको रिप्रोड्यूस करना पड़ेगा. इफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैड नॉट रिप्रोड्यूस्ड, यू नो व्हाट विल हैपन, उनकी पूरी जाति नष्ट हो जाएगी ना. दे वोंट बी अ सिंगल वन ऑफ देम लेफ्ट. सो रिप्रोडक्शन इट एंश्योर्स द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ सिमिलर काइंड्स ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स जेनरेशन आफ्टर जेनरेशन. डॉग्स अगर रिप्रोड्यूस नहीं करेंगे तो नए डॉग्स कैसे आएंगे. सिमली सी, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स. नाउ लेट अस लर्न अबाउट हाउ रिप्रोडक्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन एनिमल्स. नाउ यू हैव सीन द यंग वंस ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल्स. इन दिस टेबल यू कैन सी लाइक अ ह्यूमन baby, young one is called a baby. So a cat's young one is called a kitten. A dog's young one is called a puppy. A butterfly's young one, okay, the butterfly's young one is called a nymph. Hen's young one, chick. Cow's young one is called a calf. And a frog's young one, we call it a tadpole. Okay, so you must have seen the young ones of various animals being born. How are chicks born? How are caterpillars born? Right? You see, the chick is born from eggs. Same for caterpillars also. How are kittens and puppies born? So their mother give them birth, right? So now did the young ones look the same before they were born as they do now? So you'll say no, obviously not. The puppy or the kitten in the mom's body before birth was quite different from what they look now. A chick was quite different from after it is born. Right? So there are changes also. Now there are two modes by which animals reproduce. First is sexual reproduction and second is asexual reproduction. We will learn about both of these, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Let us first take about sexual reproduction. Okay, in reproduction in plants, we learned that male and female reproductive parts of the plants are different. Same way, like the stamen, the carpel, the androecium, gynoecium, right? Just recall it. The androecium is the male reproductive part in the plant. And the gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the plant. In animals also, males and females have different reproductive parts or organs. Like plants, the reproductive parts in animals, they also produce gametes. In males, it is called sperms, and in female, it is called eggs, or we also call it ova, ovum. and they fuse means come together to form a zygote. This zygote now further develops into an embryo, and then this embryo develops into a new individual. So this type of reproduction, beginning from the fusion of male and female gametes, is called sexual reproduction. This is the definition of sexual reproduction. A type of reproduction, you can add a type of reproduction, or the better would be the type of reproduction beginning from the fusion, means joining, right, combining of male and female gametes. Gametes are the sperms and the eggs, is called sexual reproduction. Okay, now let us find about the reproductive parts in humans, and let us study the process of reproduction in them also. So let us first take up the male reproductive system, right? So we'll first talk of this system. Now the male reproductive system include a pair of testes. Pair means there are two testes. See, in this diagram you see testes are there. So we have two testes, testes 1, testes number 2, right? So a pair of testes are there. Two sperm ducts. Ducts means pipes. You see, the sperm duct. Up here it's written sperm, but actually it is a sperm duct. Right? You see, sperm duct 1, sperm duct 2. Right? Two sperm ducts coming out from each testis. And a penis. This is the penis, right? Penis, right? So we have testes, sperm duct, and penis. The testes produce the male gamete called sperms. Remember this, right? Testes will produce the male gametes, which are called sperms. And millions of sperms are produced by the testes, millions at one time, right? Every day they are made. This is how a sperm will look, right? They have a head. This head has the genetic material called DNA, right? It has the DNA, or it has the chromosomes. These chromosomes have DNA, and they determine the genetic qualities. So if you look like your father, if your hair is like your father, that has come from the DNA or the chromosomes which the father's sperm has brought to make you, right? So your eyes, if your father's eyes are brown and your eyes are brown, it's because of these chromosomes which are in the sperm. The middle piece has a mitochondria filament, and it has energy. It powers the cell, the sperm cell. And we have a tail. So we have a head, a middle piece, and a tail. Tail is for swimming. So the sperm is like a missile. You can see it's like a missile. It's shaped like that. It has a tail which helps in swimming. The tail's movement will propel the sperm ahead. So sperms are very small in size, but their structure has a head, a middle piece, and a tail. And it's a single cell, right? See, it's a single cell. This one, we call it a human sperm cell. Right? It is one cell itself. So each sperm is a single cell with all the usual cell components. Whatever is found in a cell, in an animal cell, they are found in a sperm cell. Okay, so this is the male reproductive organs. So what purpose does a tail in the sperm serve? It helps in swimming or to move forward, right? The movement of the tail helps the sperm to swim up, to swim, right, or to move forward. Because the sperm has to travel to fertilize the egg. We will see that later. Now let us talk of the female reproductive organs. The female reproductive organs are a pair of ovaries. See, these are ovaries. Ovary number one, ovary number two, a pair of ovaries. Oviducts, also known as fallopian tubes. Again, there are pair, fallopian tube number one and fallopian tube number two. So they are oviduct. And uterus, this is the uterus. This whole, this part is called the uterus. Right? The uterus and this part actually is called the vagina. Right? This is the vagina. And the uterus and the vagina open. The uterus opens into the vagina by a narrow opening. This will be a narrow opening. This opening is called the cervix. Right? So we have a uterus. Friends, this is where the baby will develop. Yeah, this is where the baby develops. We say the baby is developing in the mother's stomach. That's a wrong thing to say. Stomach is where food is digested, right? The baby develops in the uterus of the mother. Okay? Alright. So, okay, you don't have to remember cervix and vagina right now. Just keep in mind the ovary, the fallopian tube and the uterus. Ovaries, they produce the female gametes called ova or also called eggs. Now, in sperm we saw that the testes will produce millions of sperms. That every single day sperms are being made. But in human beings, in human females, a single matured egg, one only, right, is released into the oviduct by one of the ovaries every month. So in sperms are millions, egg is only one per month. Right? So if ovary number one releases one egg in January, then ovary number two will release one egg in February, and then ovary number one again one egg in March. Right? So one egg released per month from one ovary. Uterus is the part where development of the baby takes place. Now, like the sperm, egg also is a single cell, but it is larger than the sperm. You see, the egg is quite large compared to the sperm. Okay, so a human egg, human ova looks like this. They have a nucleus in the center and the cytoplasm has other cell organelles. Now, the size of eggs in animals will vary. The human egg may be very small. Hens eggs are larger. The eggs we eat in the market are the eggs of hen. Ostrich egg is the largest egg possible. Right? Ostrich egg is the largest egg. Yeah, not largest egg possible. Because we don't know how dinosaurs' eggs looked. Yeah, if you happen to see a dinosaur egg, please let me know how it looks. And be careful, if it cracks, you're dead. Okay, no, dinosaurs are extinct, right? But yeah, their eggs must have been huge, right? Quite big, maybe like footballs. Now, let's talk of a new topic called fertilization. See, the first step in the process of reproduction is the fusion of a sperm and an ova. The fusion of the egg and the sperm is called fertilization. So when the sperms come in contact with an egg, one of the sperms may fuse with the egg. See, in this diagram you can see up here. In this diagram, see, there are three sperms which have come in contact with this egg. Only one sperm, this lucky sperm here, has managed to enter inside the egg, and once this enters, these sperms are not allowed. Right? The road is blocked. So only one sperm can enter any egg at any given time. Right? And now we can say this is called fertilization. So fertilization occurs with the fusion of a sperm and an egg, right? And this fertilization will result in a zygote. right? So this results in the formation of a fertilized egg, which is called a zygote. Now, zygote is the beginning of a new individual. So this cell, the nuclei which are fusing, form zygote. This zygote starts dividing. 1 becomes 2, 2 becomes 4, becomes 8, becomes 16, becomes 32, and then slowly the cells divide to form millions of cells, and the entire baby starts getting shape. So the process of fertilization is the meeting of an egg cell from the mother and a sperm cell from the father. Right? So remember this. The meeting of the egg cell from the mother and sperm cell from the father is called fertilization. And what happens because of that? The new individual inherits, means gets, some characters from the mother and some from the father. See, look at your brother and sister carefully. Though you may not like your brother and sister, you may always be fighting with them, but look at them carefully and you'll find that you look quite similar to your mother, to your brother or sister. You may have some traits in common. Or compare them with your father and mother, and you may find, oh yeah, my brother has a nose which looks like my father. My sister has hair which looks like my mother's. And so you see, you may have common characteristics to your father and mother. So you are a combination of characteristic of your father and mother, your grandfather, and also your grandparents. Now, fertilization which takes place inside the female body is called internal fertilization. Now, remember this. Fertilization which takes place inside the female body, that is called internal fertilization. It happens in animals like humans, cows, dogs, and hens. Now, don't say, oh, how is human an animal? We are animal beings, right? We are animals. Humans are also considered in the animal kingdom. Okay, now in some animals fertilization takes place outside the body of the female. In these animals fertilization takes place in water. We call this external fertilization. Okay? Yeah. So during spring or rainy season, frogs, toads, they move to ponds and slow moving streams. When the male and female come together in the water, the female lays hundreds of eggs. Yeah, but unlike the hen's egg, frog's egg is not covered by a shell. It is comparatively very delicate. A layer of jelly holds the eggs together and provides protection to the eggs. Something like this, you see. This jelly-like structure you can see up here surrounding the egg. So this jelly-like material holds the eggs together. It provides protection. Now, as the eggs are laid, the male deposits sperms over them. Each sperm swims randomly in water with the help of its long tail. The sperms come in contact with the eggs and fertilization will occur. So, this type of fertilization in which the fusion of a male and female gamete take place outside the body of the female is called external fertilization, and it is common in aquatic animals, the fishes like fish, starfish, even the amphibians like frog and toad and salamander, etc. So, question is, why do fish and frogs lay eggs in hundreds, whereas a hen lays only one egg at a time? Just think of it, friends. We will continue about this study in the next video. Right? We also have to understand or take one more topic called test tube babies. Let's study those in the next video. Okay, bye friends.